Hello and welcome to India for the first ISSF World Cup of the 2017 season. 452 athletes from 50 nations are competing over 7 days in 15 disciplines. With this, the first major event in the new Olympic cycle, we have a new set of rules. I'm Matthew Layton, so sit back and enjoy the best of the action. The women's 10-meter air rifle had all three athletes from the People's Republic of China in the last eight. We join the action with three athletes left in the competition. China's Dongli Ji scores a 9.9, but the noise is not for her, it's for Indian Pooja Gaktaw with a 10.7. Ice cool, Shi Meng Yao, the 19-year-old, keeps ahead with a 10.2. Pooja needs to overcome a 0.3 deficit to remain in the competition. Her previous best was fourth in a World Cup, so she's guaranteed to beat that today. No, it's not going to be, as you can hear, the size of the crowd. But Ice Cool Shi continues from strength to strength. That's a bronze medal for India in the first event. Pooja Gaktaw has made her nation proud. Two more shots to go to separate Dong and Shi from the People's Republic of China. Dong with a 9.3. Shi with a 9.7, so the nerves are settling in. One shot to go, the difference is though, a massive 3.3 in Shi's favour. Chinese always looking for perfection, taking notes. Dong finishes with an impressive 10.5. But Shi, a 10.4. It's enough to take the gold and a new world record to Shi from the People's Republic of China. Dong takes the silver and Gaktaw the bronze. Moving on to the men's 10-meter air rifle set in the universally appreciated finals hall. Peter Siddy in action, 38 years old, the only athlete from Hungary competing, a 10.3. And here's 18-year-old Shimada from Japan, a 10.1. The next shot will decide the bronze medal. No problems for Sung Baham from the People's Republic of China, maintaining his lead. Ah, Shimada from Japan in his first Senior World Cup has taken the bronze place. Song leading by 0.1. Here was fast scoring Siddy, fires first at 10.7, that gets the crowd going. But matched by 10.7 from Song. We're loving this. Gap now only 0.1, last shot of the competition. Siddy at 10.2, is it going to be enough? No, it's not. Song at 10.5, it's his first World Cup and he's won the gold medal. So that Sun Baham takes the gold for the People's Republic of China. Peter Siddy of Hungary claims the silver medal and Atase Shimada takes the bronze for Japan. The final lineup of the women's trap was only decided after a six-way shoot-off. Only three athletes left in the competition and Mopsi Verma from Finland has fired her last shot today, but this will be her best ever result. Penny Smith, the 21-year-old left-handed lifeguard from Australia, has really shown her form today. London Olympic champion Jessica Rossi, she's the one, by the way, came through the shoot-off, maintaining the touch, but she's going to regret three misses in a row a bit earlier on. Mopsi takes the bronze medal. Her best ever result was in the 1999 juniors. Two athletes left, only one hit between them. There's Adam, the Aussie coach, looking a bit nervous. Penny Smith from Australia, 21 years old, is keeping her cool. Moved to 39 shots. Jessica Rossi. 37, there's only one to go, however. Conditions have been really tough today with a strong left-to-right cross breeze. Penny Smith keeps her composure and finishes off in style. That's 40 hits. It's a new world record. Sportingly, Jessica Rossi completes in the same style, but there's no doubt about the winner today. It's Penny Smith from Australia. Jessica Rossi, silver for Italy, and third place, Mopsi Vromaa from Finland. The 25-meter rapid-fire men's competition had two athletes from China in the last three. Remember, only a score of 9.7 or above is a hit. Azerbaijan's Ruslan Nunev competes in the Rio Olympic Games. With that series of four, he takes a bronze medal. That is the first ever medal for Azerbaijan in this discipline. And now down to the last two shooters, both from the People's Republic of China, only separated by one hit at this stage. 20-year-old Lin to fire next. It's his first World Cup. The pressure just doesn't exist in his head. It's now all down to 26-year-old Lau. He has silver experience. He won the silver in Gabala World Cup 2015. Yes, that's enough. Crowd appreciate the skill. And that means gold and silver for the People's Republic of China. Lau takes the gold, Lin takes the silver, and the bronze medal to Ruslan Lunev from Azerbaijan. The men's trap was shot in bright sunshine but breezy wind, which would test the skills to the limit. We join the action with three shooters remaining. Alberto Fernandez from Spain, one of the fastest shots in the world. 47-year-old four-time Olympic medalist Giovanni Pilello from Italy next to fire. Another hit from the four-time world champion. Here we have the Italian battle of the generations with 20-year-old Simone D'Ambrosio also hitting away.
And the bronze medal representing Spain goes to Alberto Fernandez.
Fernandez is out of the competition, looks absolutely delighted. He's won a medal, 50 starters in this event. Pelliello, world rank number two, was already winning international medals before D'Ambrosio was even born. But the stress is not getting to him. Under huge pressure now, Pelliello needs to put this one away to stay in the game. Oh, and with the stress its maximum, he misses. The door is open now. The 20-year-old has done what he came to do. He's won a match. In his first World Cup final, congratulated warmly by his compatriot. And of course, the coach is delighted. That means Simone D'Ambrosio takes the gold. Pelliello takes the silver, both from Italy. And Antonio Fernandez for Spain takes the bronze. The women's 10-meter air pistol was once again dominated by the Asian continent. Yu and Qian taking fourth and fifth place for the Chinese Taipei. Loading her pistol is 28-year-old Ti Shun Shi from Singapore, trying to better the bronze she took at the Rio 2016 World Cup. A very strong 10.4, but it was a final shot of the competition, as once again she had to settle for the bronze medal. So, bronze goes to Singapore. Two athletes in the competition, and it's very close. 2016 Rio Olympic Games champion, Zhu Mengshu, only shot a 9.8, but a very impressive Lin scores a 10.7. With one shot remaining in the competition, the difference is 3.3. That is huge in Lin's favour. Something dramatic has to happen. Coach doesn't know what to think. No, that has secured victory. People's Republic of China take gold and silver with a new world record. So Lin Yumei takes the gold for the People's Republic of China. Her compatriot Zhang Mengshu the silver. The bronze medal is awarded to Tian Shunxi from Singapore. The men's 50-meter rifle three positions had three athletes from China and one from Switzerland, Hungary, Japan, Thailand and India. Japan's Toshika Yamashita was shooting slightly high. That's better with a 10.2. Peter City from Hungary was struggling and after the first round he found himself in eighth position. Sun Jian from China was leading the game. Here's Sun Jian again after the 7-minute changeover, fires a 10.2. It's his first parade shot. And he maintained his lead after the second section. Zhang Lokpila from Switzerland in second. Closely followed by local favourite Sanjeev Rajput from India. India having a cracking meeting. Now we move into the second series of five shots in the standing position. Hu Zhixian from China fights for the lead. We join the action as the battle for bronze. 24-year-old Swiss army shooter Zhang Lokpila is in unknown territory. Fires a 9, that's not going to be enough to keep him in the competition. But a very happy Lokpila takes the bronze medal. Sun Jian wobbled with his last shot with 8.8, but can he hang on for victory? Wow, that's a huge 10.6 from Hu Zhixian. He's claimed the win. Gold goes to the People's Republic of China with Hu Zhixian, silver for Sun Jian, and Switzerland's Jan Lokpila takes the bronze medal. The women's 50-meter rifle three positions had the leaders changing several times. In the first kneeling position, Swiss Nelia Christian came sixth in Rio Olympic Games, shot a solid 10.4, while Eva Roslin from Germany, who won at Marylebone 2014 World Cup, was looking for another victory, 10.1, to keep her in touch. Jasmine Serre was appearing in a fourth final of a World Cup, shot a deep 10.8 and moved up the scoreboard. At the changeover, Roslin put Christian and Serre occupying the first three positions. As we rejoin the action, Zhang Jiwen from China, who is making her World Cup debut, ruined all of the team's strength and depth. A 10.7, and she corrected herself from firing too far right. Serve Singapore was consistently firing in the high tens. As the business end of the competition approached, Kidmati Ansari left the competition with Serre holding commanding 2.2 lead. Jolene Baer grimaced as she could have done better. Serre just had a 10.5. Roskin only managed 8.7. This was to be her last shot. Eva took the bronze for Germany. With one shot remaining, Zhang from China had a 0.9 lead over Serre from Singapore. Zhang, the unknown quantity, looked like the pressure of leading in her first competition was starting to show. Only 9.3, but scored at 8.3. Zhang won her first competition for the People's Republic of China. That was their sixth gold of the week. Jasmine Serre for Singapore took silver and Eva Roskin for bronze for Germany. The men's double trap took place in top-class conditions, plenty of sunshine and good visibility. With only three shooters left in the competition, Australia's 21-year-old James Willett, who won the 2016 World Cup final, was continuing in good form. Anchor from India in his first final of the World Cup was impressing with his enthusiastic locals. While 18-year-old James Dedman from Great Britain, coached by the way by 2012 Olympic champion Peter Wilson, was having the time of his life. With just two shooters left in the competition, James Willett had a convincing three-hit lead. And fresh from his victory in the Australian National Championships, Willett couldn't seem to miss. Mittal was, however, doing his best to keep up the pressure. However, James Willett today was just too strong, hitting his last two targets, leaving Mitchell to finish off and claim the silver. So James Willett takes the gold for Australia, Anker Mitchell silver for India, and James Dedman a great bronze medal for Great Britain. The local Indian crowd were charmed by the exploits of Jitu Rai and his epic comeback in the final of the men's 10-metre air pistol. Rai had somewhere clawed his way back to the second position, having survived too many shoot-offs on his way. This was the shot to decide the bronze medal, and Rai from India was up against Huang Shivan, the Olympic champion from Rio. An 8.6. Oh, that's not good. Was surpassed by 9.3, but the heroic bronze felt like a victory to the fans. Time to calm down a bit. The 2010 world champion Tomoyuki Matsuda from Japan had established a substantial 2-point lead over Huang. Two shots to go. With the crowd still buzzing from Rai's performance, Matsuda had just to concentrate on his job in hand. A deep 10.6 to finish, let no doubting he was the victor today. In the most dramatic final to date, Tomoyuki Matsuda won the gold for Japan, Huang Shengvin the silver for Vietnam, and Jitu Rai an unforgettable bronze for India. After testing hot, breezy conditions in the qualifying, many shooters also found the finalist conditions challenging. We joined the finalists of the 50-metre prone competition, three athletes remaining. Yamashita from Japan had a 0.2 lead over Liu from China, with Daniel Romanchek from Poland 1.6 further back. It was unknown territory for the 31-year-old from Poland, competing in his first World Cup, and a 10.2 was an honourable way to bow out of the final and put himself on the international map. He comes third. Only two shots remaining and the gap is only 0.1 in Yamashita's favour. The 39-year-old was looking for his first gold medal. The 10.4 compared to Liu's 10.1, so the gap now with one shot remaining was 0.4. There goes a 10.5 for Yamashita, secures the win for the double Olympian. That's a good week's work for the Japanese coach, Thomas Farnick, in your picture. So there's the gold medal and a new world record to Toshikazu Yamashita from Japan, silver to Liu Liukan from the People's Republic of China, and bronze to the debutant Daniel Romanchek from Poland. Your hand over the ears, ladies and gentlemen. It's the loudest competition we have. It's the women 25-metre pistol. After some frantic attempts, we're down to three athletes. Nafasvan Yangpaiboon of Thailand is giving the others an exhibition in how to shoot. Two athletes, Yangpaiboon and 21-year-old Michelle Skerries, a top junior, in action. Here's Yang, arguably one of the top shooters, ex-number one in the world from the People's Republic of China. They're going head-to-head. That's all Michelle Skerries can offer today. What a great tournament. And her colleagues are really delighted with her. So she, by the way.
So one series left now to settle the gold and silver medal in his final.
But we're down to the last two. A huge gap, so it's probably going to be academic. And there's no wonder the Thai coach is looking delighted. Yangpaiboon can't do anything wrong, although she did only score three in the last two series. That was certainly enough to claim this magnificent victory. As you can see, there's only one athlete in it today, a huge victory. Nashwan Yangpaiboon of Thailand takes the gold. Zhang Yi from China takes the silver. And Michelle Skerries from Germany takes the bronze medal. The 50-metre men's free pistol was guaranteed to be a rowdy affair with two Indians in the final. But Tomoyuki Matsuda from Japan, who won the 10-metre, was looking and taking in his stride. Arpit Singh from India had a mid-final lead of 6 points, but Rai was slowly coming back. He'd come back from the sixth position. The crowd couldn't believe he could do it twice in a week. And as we go, we only have three athletes left in the competition. Zahid Golden-Gan from the Islamic Republic of Iran. He was going in his first competition. Rai is sneaking up all the way. The crowd can't bear it. And Vahid takes an honourable bronze medal. India is guaranteed a gold and a silver. Two shots remaining. Singh leading Rai by 0.3. Singh fires first, an 8.8. But Rai's 10 has now taken him into the lead for the first time. One shot remaining, and the fans were loving every second of it. Singh scored an 8.8. He's gone and done it at 10.5, bringing the crowd to their feet and claiming the gold medal for India. And Preet Singh takes the silver medal for India, with Vahid Golden-Gan winning the bronze for Iran. Near perfect conditions awaited the six finalists for the women's skeet final. After some top shooting, three athletes remained in the competition. Shatia Juchalamet from Thailand, with two World Cup victories to her name, had no trouble hitting both targets on station four. Shooting legend Kimberly Rhodey was loving the battle. But there's an uncharacteristic miss, but she's still sitting on a big lead. Here comes Chloe Tipple, competing in her first final. She's making many admirers, but this time has to settle for a bronze medal in New Delhi. Down to the last two, Rhodey with a four-target lead over Juchalamet. Imagine having to make up a huge gap against the only woman athlete ever to have medaled in six consecutive Olympic Games. It wasn't going to be easy. With a miss in the last pair, it was going to now be impossible. There's Kimberly Rhodey, looking like she could keep going, hitting targets all day. Finishing off in style, a new world record, and claims the gold medal. So Kimberly Rhodey, gold for the United States of America, Sujita Juchalamet, silver Thailand, and Chloe Tipple takes the bronze for New Zealand. Now down to the last event of New Delhi 2017, and it's the men's skeet final. Gabriele Rossetti, 21 years old, Olympic champion, former world junior champion, had an extraordinary start. And here's Paul Adams. Topped the qualifications for most of the time. His coach is absolutely delighted with his performance, really surpassed himself today, just dropping the last target. That's going to almost certainly put him in bronze. This is the man on form, Riccardo Filippelli, 36 years old, 2016 European champion. You won't ever see anyone more concentrated than this. He's really in the zone today. And Paul Adams is able to relax and savour his wonderful performance today. No loose situation for the Italian, really. First and second. But Rossetti can't afford that. He's starting to drop a few targets and he thinks it's all over. That's enough. Riccardo Filippelli is going to continue, but he knows he's won. Look at that. I'm the top dog today. Italy 1, Italy 2. Second time in the week we've seen this. Riccardo Filippelli takes gold for Italy. Gabriele Rossetti, silver for Italy. And Paul Adams takes the bronze for Australia. Well, that's all for us today from New Delhi. See you soon in Acapulco. And remember, the World Cup final is back here in New Delhi in October.